Welcome to our YouTube channel, Bharat Test Guru. Today we're gonna talk about money, various types of money, marketing concepts which are related to the money. At first, we know the definition of money. Money defines as a medium of exchange. If you want to purchase something, either it may be a product or goods, it requires money. For getting the product or item, we are paying some amount, some money. Here we are exchanging the product with money. So money acts as a medium of exchange. Types of money. Here we have some types of monies. Have a look. Fiat money, commercial money, commodity money, and representation money. Commodity money. Commodity is nothing but a product or an item. It is in raw material. Here, commodity money. Money value derived from the commodity out of which it is made. Here, based on the type of commodity, type of product, the money value is to be decided. Here we have some examples: gold, silver, copper, and salt. For different products, for different commodities, gold and silver. For different gold, we are giving some money value. For silver, we are giving some money value. For copper also. Here for different items, we are giving different money values. Next. Fiat money. This money is also called fiat currency. This does not have any intrinsic value, means it does not backed by any physical commodities like gold and silver. It is based on the relationship between the supply and demand rather than the materials. In fiat money, it is depends on the supply and demand. For examples, here paper money is there. One more examples we can say US dollar. It is based on supply and demand. Next, commercial bank money. These banks make money by providing loans, earning interest income from those loans which can be used for purchasing goods and services. Commercial banks providing loans for customers. From these loans they are getting some interest incomes, and from the customer deposits also they are getting some incomes. From with the these money they are that banks are purchasing some goods and services. Next, representative money. It is the money that include token coins or physical tokens like certificates that can be exchanged for a fixed amount of commodity like gold and silver. It can be exchanged on a demand for a commodity that has some intrinsic value. Here the physical quantities are gold and silver. They have some particular value. For this value, we are exchanging some money value. Here, they have some intrinsic value. Next, money calculated as. Money can be calculated by five types. Here, M0, M1, M2, M3 and M4. M0 is also called as reverse money. It is currency in circulation plus bankers' deposits with RBI. Means currency which are with the public and bankers deposit, which banks are deposits with RBI plus other deposits with RBI. Other than the bank deposits, RBI will consist some deposits is equals to net RBI credit to the government plus RBI credit to the commercial sector plus RBI claims on banks plus RBI net is foreign assets plus government security liabilities to the public minus RBI net non-monetary liabilities. Next, M1, all deposits with RBI plus currency circulation in country plus demand deposits of the banks. Demand deposits means it is payable by demand like fixed deposits, self-help groups, non-priority sectors, gold loans, all come under the M1 category. This is also called narrow banking. M1 is also called as narrow banking. Next, M2. M2 called M1 plus saving deposits under the post offices. Here M1 consists of all deposits with RBI, currency circulation in country and demand deposits. Along with these, M2 consists of saving bank deposits under post offices. For example, core banking system comes under the M2. Next, M3. M1 plus term deposits. Here M2 is M1 plus saving deposits. Here M3 is M1 plus term deposits with banks. M4. M3 plus all other deposits of post offices. except NSC bonds. Here NSC bonds are national savings certificates. Four pillars of marketing. Here we have some marketing concepts. Pillars, they are product, price, place and promotion. Here product is there. Product is nothing but which is satisfies the customer needs. The major important aim is for any product, it has to satisfy the customer needs. Here we will get quality, brand, warranty, service and packaging. All these comes under the product. Next, price. Price should be optimum. It should be reasonable for the any customer. It is according to the budget. Discounts, payments period, credit terms, list price and bundling. These all comes under the price. Next, place. Place is nothing but user getting the products from which, from the customer, sorry, user is getting the product from the producer. In what way? From the producer, user is getting whether retailer or wholesaling or direct sales or e-commerce, nothing but online shopping. Next, promotion. This is the major role in the product selling. Promotion will play the major role in the product selling. Here we will get advertising, special offers, direct marketing, direct mailing and posters. All these are comes under the promotions. Here we have product. In marketing, a product is anything that can be offered to a market that might satisfy a want or need. The product has to be satisfies the wants or needs of customers. Next, price. Pricing strategy in marketing is the pursuit of identifying the optimum price for a product. Here, price has to be optimum price for a product. Next, distribution or place. The process of moving products from the producer to the intended user is called place. As already I said, user is getting the product from the producer. From where, from which source he is getting, either from retailer or wholesaler or online shopping, none other than e-commerce. Next, promotion. In marketing, promotion is advertising a product or brand, generating sales or creating brand loyalty. Product has to be satisfying the brand loyalty. Next, marketing concepts. It is also a process of accepting the product. Marketing is nothing but process of accepting the product. Here we have some marketing concepts. Production concept, product concept, societal marketing concept, marketing concept and selling concept. Marketing concept is a process of customers accepting the product. The process of customer accepting the product is nothing but a marketing concept. There are different types of marketing, as I said, production, product concept and selling concept and marketing concept. We will say production. The idea of production concept. Consumers will favor products that are available and highly affordable. This concept is one of the oldest marketing management orientations that guides sellers. The product has to be available in the market in a high manner. It should be available every time, each and every time. It should be available in the market. Product concept. Product concept holds that the consumers will favor products that offer the most in quality, performance and innovative features. The product has to be high in quality. It has to be high quality and it is showing good performance, better performance and having unique features. Then only it should be survive in the market. Selling concept. The selling concept holds the idea consumers will not buy enough of the firm's products unless it undertakes a large scale selling and promotion effort. Selling concept plays a major role in the marketing concept. Unless we are doing the promotions, the product is not to be highlighted. Next, marketing concept. The marketing concept holds achieving organizational goals depending on knowing the needs and wants of target markets and delivering the desired satisfactions better than competitors do. Unless we are doing the better needs, better product delivery, then only we can survive in the marketing field. Consumer first have to introduce product by an innovative way. We have to product consumer first approach, customer first approach. We have to give the product very soonly. Next, social market concept. The social market concept holds marketing strategy should deliver value to customers in a way that maintains or improves both the consumers and society's well-being. In social market concept, both the company and as well as consumer are in profitable state. Consumer is satisfied with the product as well as the company will be profits. The company has in the profits by selling that particular product. Here both will be beneficial, consumers as well as company. Next, money market instruments. Money market, here we have six types of money market instruments: call and short notice money, certificate of deposits, treasury bills, commercial bills, commercial papers and repurchase agreements. Here we have money market instruments. The money market can be defined as a market for short-term money and financial assets that are mere substitutes for money. The term short-term means generally a period up to 1 year, and mere substitutes to money is used to denote any financial asset which can be quickly converted into money with minimum transaction cost. So we'll see what is money market. It is a short term. That means up to 1 year, less than 1 year. We'll see. Next, call money or notice money is the money borrowed or lent on demand for very short period. When money is borrowed or lent for a day, it is known as call money. Overnight, within 24 hours, if you give the short term period, is 24 hours only, then it is called call or notice money. Main features of call money market. Market for a short term, yes, it is obviously, it is, we are giving overnight, no fixed geographical locations. Advertisement. Major institutes involved in money market, which are money market, major institutes are involved in money market are RBI, commercial banks, LIC, Life Insurance Corporation and GIC, General Insurance Corporation. All these institutions are providing money market instrumentation. The common instruments of money market are call money, treasury bills, commercial papers, certificates of deposits and commercial bills. Here we have treasury bills. Treasury bills are short term, up to 1 year, borrowing instruments of the Union Government. Here we can see the treasury bills. The maturity period for the treasury bills are commonly it is 28 days or nearly 1 month, 91 days, 3 months or 182 days, it is 6 months, 364 days, about 1 year. Treasury bills, it can be matured before the 1 year. Certificate of deposits, receipt issued by depository institution such as bank, credit union or finance or insurance company, either banks, credit unions, financial institutions, insurance company, whichever it may be, the receipt issued by all these companies to a depositor who opens a certificate account or time deposit account. Here we can see the certificate of deposit. Certificate of deposit, it matures in within 7 days to 1 year. Maturity period for the certificate of deposit is 7 days to 1 year. For financial institutions, the maturity period is differs. It is 1 year to 3 years. It is not less than a 1 year. It is not more than a 3 years. Except this financial institution, all over banks, credit unions and insurance companies, it is less than 1 year. Here we have some important features of certificate of deposit. We have some important features. It will be almost negligible risk, and certificate of deposit is considered as riskless because default risk in them is almost negligible, and hence it is safe bet for investors. For investors it is less risk, almost it is a negligible. Next, second one, certificate of deposit is highly liquid and marketable, and hence investors can buy or sell it whenever they decide to do so. Certificates of deposits can be provided by insurance companies and financial institutions and banks. So it is highly liquidity in the market. Hence, the investor can buy or sell whenever they may be decide. Whenever the investor wants to buy or sell, they can easily buy the certificate of deposits. Next, third one, they are transferable from one party to another, which cannot be done with term deposit, and hence it is added advantage for investors who are willing to invest in it. Certificate of deposits can be transferable from one party to another party. It is not done in the term deposit, so it is one more advantage in the certificate of deposits. Here, commercial paper, an unsecured obligation issued by corporation or bank to finance its short-term credit needs such as accounts receivable and inventory. Commercial paper is available in a wide range of denominations, can be either discounted or interest bearing, and usually have a limited non-existing secondary market. Commercial papers are not existing like certificates of deposit. It is unsecured short-term debt instrument. Maturity period for commercial paper is 270 days. Here we can see commercial paper. Next, commercial papers have following advantages. It is a cost-effective way of financing working capital. It is cheaper than the bank loans. Next, advertisement. It is required to be rated. Good rating reduces the cost of capital of the company. If rating will be, the rating of commercial paper will increase, or capital of the company will be reduces. Next, commercial papers suffer from the following demerits. Demerits also there for commercial papers. You can see it is available to few selected blue chip and profitable companies. It is not available for all. It is only available for the few selected companies like blue chip companies and profitable companies only. Next, by issuing commercial papers, the credit available from banks may get reduced. Here already we said if we increase the commercial paper rating, the cost of capital of company will be reduced. Next, issue of commercial paper is strictly regulated by RBI. Commercial papers are regulated by RBI only, not as like a certificate of deposits. It may be provided by insurance companies or financial institutions. It only regulated by RBI only. Next, interbank term money. Interbank term money market for deposits of maturity beyond 14 days is referred to as the term money market. Beyond the 14 days, call money is before the overnight periods, but the term money is beyond the 14 days is referred to as term money market. Here we have features of term deposits, fixed interest rate, fixed term. Fixed interest rate. Unlike savings account, a term deposit has a fixed rate, so market changes won't affect your earnings. Based on the money markets, in that money markets, the interest rate will be swapping, means today's rating won't be for tomorrow's, but in the fixed term deposit, the interest rate is fixed. Here they won't affect the earnings. Next, fixed term. The next thing to be considered is how long you have to put your money away for. A term deposit lasts for a predetermined amount of time. Here, how long you want to put your money away for. It may be 1 month, 3 months, 6 months, 1 year, 2 years, or 5 to 10 years, the fixed amount of time will be there in fixed term deposits. Here we have questions related to the topic which are frequently asked in the previous exams like IBPS and SSC. We will see all of the following money market instruments except, here we can see options, certificate of deposit, commercial paper, Indian depository scheme and commercial bills. Certificate of deposit, commercial paper and commercial bill, these three are money market instruments, whereas Indian depository scheme is represented for money this capital market. Next, which of the following segments of money market is indicator of day to day interest rate? Which of the following segments of money market is indicator of day to day interest rate? The answer is call money market, B. Next, who among the following is eligible to issue commercial paper? Commercial papers are issued by whom? Corporates, primary dealers, financial institutions or all of the above? The answer is all of the above. Commercial papers can be issued by corporates, primary dealers and financial institutions, but they have their capital of above 5 crore. Which of the following is not money market instrument? Options is there, national savings certificate, 3-month certificate of deposit, treasury bill to 7-day maturity and 14-day purchase agreement. Money market is a before 1 year, less than 1 year has to be maturity period. Here for national savings certificate, it is not a money market, it is a capital marketing. So option is national savings certificate. Certificate of deposit first issued in the year of, certificate of deposits is issued in the year of 1989. Here the end of the section. Thank you, Prasad sir. Thank you for watching. Please do like and subscribe us for more topics.